Everyone in Nacogdoches knew Tom Ames. There comes to some bad end. With a shepherd calling, stealing chickens and such by the time he was 10. And one day his daddy took a $10 bill and tucked it in his hand. He said, I could tell you're headed for trouble, son, and your mama wouldn't understand. So he took that money and his brother's old band and left without a word of thanks. Fell in with a crowd in some border town and it took to robbing banks. Outside the law, your luck will run out fast, and the fears came and went. Till it's trapped in an alley in Abilene with all four shells spent. And he realized praying was the only thing that he had never tried. Well, he wasn't sure that he knew quite how, but he looked up to the sky. He said, you don't owe me nothing, and as far as I know, Lord, don't owe nothing to you. Well, I ain't asking for a miracle, Lord, just a little bit of luck would do. And you know I ain't never prayed before, but it always seemed to me that praying's the same as begging, Lord, and I don't take no charity. Every right now, Lord, when I'm back to the wall, I can't help but recall how they nearly hung me for stealing a horse in Fort Smith, Arkansas. Judge Parker said guilty and the gavel came down just like a cannon shot. And I went away quietly and I began to file and plot. Well, they sent the preacher down to my cell. They said the Lord is your only hope and he's the only friend that you're gonna have when you hit the end of Parker's rope. I guess he could have kept on preaching at Christmas, but he turned his back on me. And I put a homemade blade to that golden throat and asked the deputy for the key. First close call I ever had, as I'm sure you already know, I've had some help from you, Lord, and the devil himself. It's been strictly touch and go. Yeah, but who in the hell am I talking to? Ain't no one here but me. And then he cocked both his pistols and he spit in the dirt and he walked out in that street.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.